Hi guys, so welcome to our next problem. So this time, so quadratic equations tayo. So ito yung problem na nilagay ko sa PowerPoint na hopefully sana sinagutan nyo. Of course, walang solution yan. So answer lang yung nilagay ko dun. Okay, so let's try to solve this one. So using completing the squares. Okay. So of course, kung papansinin natin yung given, so that's 2x multiplied by quantity 3 minus x equals to 3. So, hindi siya naka-standard form, di ba? Kasi ang standard form nito is in this form, ax squared, di ba, ng quadratic equation. So, ax squared plus bx plus c is equals to 0, where a, b, and c are coefficients. So, hindi siya standard form. So, at least to make it this one, or para maging kamukha nito, so we need to distribute 2x, di ba? So, simplify pa natin. So, of course, 2x times 3, so that's 6x. So, 2x minus x, so negative 2x squared is equals to 3. Tama? Then, to make this positive, di ba? Kasi positive yan. So, we divide the whole equation by negative 1. So, para maging positive. Then, we rearrange. So, lagyan sa unahan yun. So, negative 2 divided by negative 1. So, that's positive 2 na, 2x squared. Then, negative, Then, 6x divided by negative 1. So, negative 6x yan. So, of course, ito kaya naman natin. 3 divided by negative 1. So, negative 3. So, yun. Then, kung papansinin natin, so, before nga pala tayo mag-apply na completing the squares, tandaan nyo to guys, always make sure na yung coefficient ng x squared mo ay 1. Diba? So, dapat walang coefficient yung x squared pag mag-completing the squares. Pero kung, let's say, gagamit ka ng quadratic equations, okay lang yan. Or kung factoring, kasi kung factorable naman to, pwede. Pero in this case, hindi siya factorable kasi. So, we cannot use factoring dito. So, completing the squares talaga to. Or quadratic equations. So, yun. Or the quadratic formula, sorry. Using quadratic formula, pwede rin yan. So, this time, so, if completing the squares, so, yun nga, dapat ang coefficient ng x squared mo ay 1. So, to do that, so, we divide the whole equation by 2. Diba? So, 2x squared divided by 2, so that's x squared minus negative 6x divided by 2, so that's 3x, diba? Negative 3x equals to negative 3 halves. Ayan. So, ayan na. So, in this form, identify natin yung k. So, what is your k? Diba 3? So, ayan. So, itong 3 na to, so i-add natin yung k over 2 squared, diba? So, dito both sides. So, that is, so x squared minus 3x plus k over 2, which is 3 halves, di ba? K over 2, 3 halves squared. So, both sides yan. So, negative 3 halves plus 3 halves squared. And what is 3 over 2 squared? Di ba 9 over 4? So, it becomes x squared minus 3x plus 9 over 4 is equals to negative 3 halves plus 9 over 4. So, yun na. Of course, di ba, if you remember dun sa PowerPoint natin, that PowerPoint presentation that I discussed, so, bakit ba tayo nagko-completing the squares? Ang main goal kasi natin, guys, is to make the left side, ito, a perfect square. So, of course, perfect square na yan, di ba? So, ano yung factor niyan? So, ang shortcut natin, di ba? So, x, di ba? Then, minus. Ano yung k over 2 natin? So, ang k over 2 natin is, what? 3 halves, di ba? K natin kasi is 3 over 2. So, 3 halves. Ayan. Then, squared. So, pag in-expand nyo yan, ito yan. Tama. Ayan. Equal. So, add mo lang yan. So, negative 3 halves plus 9 over 4. So, what will be your answer there? So, using LCD. So, 4, di ba? For ang LCD niyan. So, 4 divided by 2 is 2 times negative 3. So, negative 6. So, 4 divided by 4, 1 times 9 plus 9. So, that is, so, x minus 3 over 2 squared is equals to, so, negative 6 plus 9. So, that's, what? 3 over 4. Ah. Then, ito na yung ating resulting equation now. So, this time, so, gagamit tayo ng square root method, di ba? So, kunin natin yung square ng both sides. So, next page na tayo. Hindi na kasi kasya. Ayan. So, using square root method, guys. So, ayan. So, let's try to use square root method. Ayan. Balik tayo na. may ano kasi. So, using square root method, so, sulat ulit natin yung ano, equation. So, that is x minus 3 halves squared is equals to 3 over 4. So, by square root method, diba? So, what we do, sorry, so, ito nyo naman. So, square natin yung both sides, diba? Get the square of both sides. So, of course, pag ni-square niya yan, so, mawala na yung square. So, square root. May x minus 3 halves na lang, di ba? So, equal. So, square nito. Pag, di ba, pag sa square root method, if we square the right side, so, mag-a-add tayo ng plus minus kasi dalawang root na yan. So, that's square root of 3 over, what is square root of 4? 2. Then, if we transpose this one sa kabila, so, your x is equals to plus minus square root of 3 over 4 plus 3 halves. Or, ang gusto nyo, ah sorry, 2 pala to, 2, not 4. Duling naman ako. Ayan. So, or you can combine them into 1. So, that is x equals, since pares yung denominator, so it becomes plus minus square root of 3 plus 3 over 2. So, pwedeng yan yung sagot. Or, kung gusto mo ipang paghiwalayin yan, so ano yung dalawang roots? So, x1, first root mo, so kung ano yung positive nito, so square root of 3 plus 3 over 2 and yung unang root. Then, ano yung sumunod na root? Or, ito, yung negative naman. So, negative square root of 3 plus 3 over 2. Eh, di ba yung sagot dun sa PowerPoint na? So, ayan. So, either of the two will do. So, kahit ito. So, ito kasi yun pag pinagsama sa isa. Or, kahit yung dalawa. So, ayun guys. So, that's how you solve this problem. So, using completing the squares. So, very important na tandaan nyo guys, bago kayo mag-completing the squares, dapat, yung dito guys, yung coefficient ng x squared mo should be 1. Okay, so dapat ganyan. So, wag na wag kayo mag-completing the squares na ang factor nyo dito ay meron kayong coefficient pa dito. Okay, so yun lang naman guys. So, on our next video, so we'll try to solve problems involving equations na may radicals. Okay? So, try natin yan. Ayun lang, guys. Thank you.